Number two pick. First down, Alfred Morris. And Morris with a first down. Gets it out to the 28-yard line, picking up 16. Alfred Morris, that's his longest run of the game. Redskins need a touchdown to take the lead. Remember, Caleb Sturgis missed a field goal and an extra point in this game. Here's Morris again. Get a feeling Morris may be getting on track as late as it is at this point, David.
Yes, it really is. And this is the time where they need to take advantage of it and continue to move forward, because if they can get the runs going, that's where they've been able to open up their passing game, get the play action, and take a shot. But this is not a time where you press. But as an offense, you've got to have a sense of urgency here, because you know right now this is the most important drive of the football game.
Chris Thompson replaces Morris in the backfield with under 5 minutes to go. Here is Thompson. An Eagle gets a hand on him. And remember, the running play is not going to be bad for the Eagles, but for the Redskins, they've got to get downfield. They need the touchdown, not the field goal here. And the clock runs with 4:40 remaining. Now it's third down and one.
You asked me earlier, what should they do? I said, put it on the offensive lineman. They came up short. Once again, what are you going to do? Are you going to put it on the offensive lineman who didn't come up? Or are you going to throw it? And it looks like they're going to throw it.
Maybe it's two down territory for them. Cousins completes it for the first down to Reed. Jordan Reed with the first down catch. Let's go out to L.A. for a game break and join Mike Hill.
All right, guys, Giants trying to finish strong in the fourth quarter for a change in Buffalo. Look at this effort by Rashard Jennings on third down. Makes a player miss, and then Bakari Rambo just get out of the way. Touchdown, 51-yard touchdown. Going for two is 22-10 Giants in the fourth.
All right, Mike, and we'll get to the NFC East standings as the Giants going to Buffalo and taking the 22-10 lead. Play action for Cousins on first down, and miscommunication between Rashard Ross and Kirk Cousins. Talking about that NFC East, the Dallas Cowboys will play the Saints later tonight, and Drew Brees will start for New Orleans. But the Giants trying to get to 2-2 and leading in the fourth quarter. And one of these teams will also get to 2-2, David.
Yes, they will. And this is a division that is wide open. But everybody knows how important this game is right here. The only guarantee that you get into the playoffs with a home field advantage is by winning your division.
And this is the first division home game that the Redskins have played this season. Second and 10. Cousins going underneath. Bryant is down. And the pass is caught by Derek Carrier. But there's a penalty on the far side of the field. This is the 18th penalty of the game, and it'll go against Philadelphia.
Water quarterback is still in the pocket. Holding. Defense, number 23. 5-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
Nolan Carroll holding on the play, and it'll be an automatic first down. That's a critical penalty against the Eagles right here.
It really is. I mean, we have already over 180 yards in penalties in this football game, and it started with the first play of the game. I don't see where the penalty is on that one.
Certainly not after 5 yards. First and 10 at the 42 now for the Redskins. Each team has all three timeouts remaining. Here's Morris breaking it. Alfred Morris. Notice how he protected the ball with both hands as he was going down at the 45-yard line. Connor Barwin making the tackle for 13. Very alert and smart play by Alfred Morris.
Changed the tone here. Now four rushes this and only two passes in this drive. But nice job at the point of attack. Getting everybody clogged up, giving him a two-way go, whether he wants to go outside or inside. Being patient, letting that block set up and cutting it up.
Morris's longest run was 16. He now is the leading rusher today for Washington. First and 10 at the 45. And they go to Morris again. And tell you what, he's a streak runner for sure. Bo Allen brings him down.
We thought they were going to start the game this way, but obviously they're looking to close the game this way. I mean, at this point, you really don't have to run a play because you've got the two-minute warning, but they're going to.
Second down and seven. This is the eighth play of a drive. A drive that's been just under 4 minutes. Pass is caught by Ryan Grant, and he gets another first down for the Redskins. And now we'll get down to the two-minute warning on the 34-yard line. First down for the Redskins, trailing by four, needing a touchdown to take the lead.
Today's game is sponsored by Lowe's. Hurry in this week for great fall savings.
2 minutes to go in regulation. The Eagles lead 20-16. This has been a game of two different halves as Kirk Cousins and Bradford dueling. Redskins led 13-0 at halftime with a really relentless pass rush. And then in the second half, with Sam Bradford getting time, he took advantage of it, David Deal.
Sam Bradford getting time, turnovers by the defense created. Put them in the position right now where they're winning.
And a first down on the 34 for Washington. They use Chris Thompson in there. He's rushed the 53 yards. And he has caught two passes as well. Cousins looking for his second career game-winning drive in the fourth quarter. Crowder holds on to it, gets to the 30-yard line. Biggers on the defense, picking up four.
I've been in this position before in an NFC East game, and you realize how important it is to, number one, be disciplined in this spot, but number two, your playmakers have got to step up and make a play for you.
Second down and six, and the out to Grant, and incomplete. Cannot hold on to the ball. Tell me how tense it is in a huddle when you're going down and try to win a game like this.
It's not tense, but everybody's extremely focused because you know this is the only opportunity that you feel you have to win this football game. And the next play is the most important play of the game.
Quarterback, only guy talking?
Only one talking. He's the only one. Eyes are all on him. He's the general, and you're going to follow the orders.
Third down and six. Under a minute and a half to go. Big play. Cousins. Flag down. Cousins getting away. And Cousins is going to dive for the first down pending the call. The flag down at the 40-yard line. And an 8-yard gain. Two penalty markers down, one at the line of scrimmage.
There are two fouls on the play.
And one downfield.
One against each team. Holding. Offense, number 75. Holding. Defense, number 23. These fouls all set. We play third down.
So Brandon Sheriff, the number one pick out of Iowa, the rookie, holding on one side. And I'm not sure whether it was Nolan Carroll. It was holding defensively in the secondary for the Eagles, but we saw the first flag go down against Sheriff, didn't we?
Right guard right here. You see that hand hooked, holding the grab.
Offsetting penalties. Third down and six again. Crowder in motion toward the line. Here's Cousins. And Cousins pass. And it's caught to the 15-yard line. Pierre Garçon and a first down. As we wind down to a minute remaining, each Eagles have three timeouts left. The Redskins have two.
Walter Thurman jumped that route, but Pierre Garçon showing his strength and his toughness to be able to pull that one out and make that catch.
12th play coming up. They've used over 5 minutes, needing a touchdown. Nothing less will do for the Redskins. And the pass incomplete to Jordan Reed. But it stops the clock with 42 seconds remaining.
Jordan Reed is down right now.
Reed is shaken up. Fletcher Cox earlier for the Eagles, but he came back into the game. It'll be second down and 10 from the 16. We want to welcome our viewers to FedEx Field. Dick Stockton along with David Deal and Christina Pink. The Redskins led 13-0 at the half. The Eagles have come back to take a 20-16 lead with 42 seconds remaining. And the Redskins on the move, and Jordan Reed, the tight end, walking off on his own power.
The Washington Redskins were just charged with a timeout. They had three, but due to the injury inside the two-minute drill, they're going to be forced, and they take away one of their timeouts, so now only two.
One, actually.
Oh, I'm sorry.
One timeout left.
One timeout.
So the Redskins needing a touchdown to pull this game out. Eagles also missed the field goal and an extra point. So it's a four-point deficit. Second down and 10. Pump fake by Cousins. Passing underneath and to the five-yard line. And that was Pierre Garçon, who's been a big weapon in this final drive for the Redskins. And a timeout called by Washington.
Their second.
They still have one timeout left.
Please reset the game clock.
They still have one timeout remaining.
35 seconds on the game clock.
See, I thought so. They didn't remove it from the scoreboard. That's why I was sitting there when I said before the 2 minute, I thought they had two.
It was 10-0 and 13-0 in favor of the Redskins at halftime. The Eagles with three touchdown passes by Sam Bradford in the second half, outscoring Washington 20-3. One of these teams will go to 2-2. Dallas plays tonight against New Orleans, and the Giants leading by two touchdowns at Buffalo. And right here, it's first and goal from the four. Kirk Cousins throwing it out of the end zone. Crowder, the rookie from Duke, was back there. Now it'll be second and goal.
Only rush four, play coverage. Good first down stop for the Philadelphia Eagles.
Redskins coming in, trying to rebound from their loss to the Giants a week ago Thursday. Eagles trying to make it two in a row. And it comes down to this. Chris Thompson, the running back, split wide left to the bottom of your picture. Just a half a minute remaining. Looking that way, the pass is caught. Touchdown to Garçon. As they do all scoring plays, was Pierre Garçon in? Great pass and pretty good defense by the Eagles as well, David.
That time they brought the blitz. Kirk Cousins knew he had to get rid of that one quickly. And who does he go to? Pierre Garçon, who has had a phenomenal drive on this series.
So Kirk Cousins throwing 45 passes today, completing 30. And the extra point attempt by Dustin Hopkins, and the kick is good. 15 plays, 90 yards for Jay Gruden's Redskins. Trying to get to 2-2, winning a divisional game at home, and for Chip Kelly, the Eagles have not really gotten to where they wanted to be early in this